Hello, this is Iyaki TV. My name is Dr. Jörg Kleine-Tebbe from Berlin, Germany, and I have two guests here. It's Professor Vicky Cardona from Barcelona in Spain, and it's Professor Paolo Matricardi from Berlin, Germany, but also having strong bonds to Italy. So please tell me, your interest is molecular allergology. What does it mean, please?
Oh, it's really, it means that it's a new way of diagnosing and seeing allergy. So it's going deeper into what is the cause of the allergic diseases, and it describes better what the causes are related to the triggering symptoms, and explains, for an example, cross-reactivities, genuine sensitizations. So it's really one step further.
So I guess we are talking about allergic rhinoconjunctivitis, allergic asthma, also food allergies, and other IgE-mediated diseases.
That's right. It's always IgE-mediated disease that we're talking
so,
in this case.
Paolo, you have always been interested in how far these allergenic molecules, these proteins, will evolve over time and create disease. So can you tell us about the evolution?
Yes, so we had a chance to study birth cohorts, so a group of children from birth up to the adolescence, and we observed that the sensitization to a pollen or to mites started with one or two molecules first in a very simple and weak way, and then is growing like a cascade that we have called molecular spreading, involving other molecules, other allergenic molecules of the same pollen or of the mite body, so become more complex, and this process is causing more problems to the patient.
So is it of any interest for the clinician? Because you, Vicky, you're really diagnosing and treating patients using allergenic molecules. Does it help to know when they interfere with the individual patient?
Definitely, because you get knowledge on many aspects like severity, which is closely related to the number of molecules that a patient recognizes, for an example. And also it helps you to make decisions, therapeutic decisions, because you can tell a patient avoid this or don't avoid this, or if you are thinking about immunotherapy, it tells you also which ones will be the best candidates to really have a good outcome.
So talking about immunotherapy, it's a very important treatment for us as allergists, and we are selecting it on the sensitizations of the patients. So what is your view as an allergoimmunologist, Paolo, in how far the repertoire of different allergens might play a role in terms of the success of immunotherapy?
Oh, it is a fundamental role, and molecular allergology really allows to have at least two major changes in our approach in allergen immunotherapy. The first one is linked to what I said before, molecular spreading. As we know today, that children start with a simple response to some initiators, and then this response is becoming more complex with time.
And then it's more difficult.
Then
it's more difficult to treat them, or?
Well, it is, let's say that it's like in the education of a child. If a child starts to do something wrong, the mother immediately stops this behavior and educates him. We have to do the same with our immune system, and so start early to recognize the disease and treat it with allergen immunotherapy as early as possible when the response is still weak. If we wait too much, then it may be more difficult to re-educate a system like an older child that is now an adolescent to change his behavior. Yeah. So I think earlier is better. And this is the first thing that we have produced with the new diagnostic approach to allergen immunotherapy.
So I think the important message is that indeed the molecular allergology approach for diagnostics will really help to consult the patient in a more precise way, and also to make decisions in terms of immunotherapy, and also judge, for example, clinical reactions in a better way. From that point of view, it has really an impact on our daily routine. Thank you very much, Professor Cardona and Professor Matricardi, and thanks for watching Iyaki TV.